Here's another thing. This is the most pervasive. This is the most pernicious. This is the most subversive. Take any adjective that you want. Red flag laws. He's implying here that they would reduce suicides, domestic violence incidents, mass shootings. This is the crux of what they want to do because it grants them the most amount of control. And I will say this. Red flag laws, as he is outlining them, would be the greatest violation of your fundamental human rights that we've endured in our lifetime. So let me show you what he's claiming, and then let me explain to you why that is and why every single person at the Change My Mind that's coming out tomorrow, liberals, mind you, vaccine virtue signalers said, oh, wow, now that I know what it is, no, of course I don't support that.
Yeah.
Here's his claim.
I wanted to make it easier for states to adopt extreme risk protection order laws. They're also called red flag laws, which everybody in this lawn knows, but many people listening do not know. These laws allow a police or family member to petition a court in their jurisdiction and say, I want you to temporarily remove from the following people any firearm they may possess because they're a danger and a crisis. They're presenting a danger to themselves and to others.
Okay. So first off, I often say that at first glance, at first hearing, that you go, well, okay, that makes sense. If you just listened to what he said and you didn't get chills down your spine, you don't know what you were hearing. Mm. That doesn't even start off from a point of making sense. Let me be clear here, okay? Right now, if you're a violent felon, you cannot purchase a firearm. Right now, if you're a violent domestic abuser, you cannot legally purchase a firearm, okay? These are already laws. And of course, there are background checks that already exist. The red flag laws, which by the way, have been happening state to state, so we have some evidence as to how they've been abused, but he wants to set a national sort of template for a red flag law within 60 days and then make it easier and of course, exert pressure on states to adopt it. What does this actually mean? A red flag law, he just said police or family member. Police, family member, friends, neighbors, doctors. Basically, they can say, hey, this person is a danger, and I don't think that they should have firearms. And so you, right now, having not committed a crime, having been convicted of no crime, charged of no crime, not even having had a trial or the opportunity to face your accusers, can have the police come into your house in the middle of the night and seize your firearms. And then later on down the line, maybe you get to go to court and a judge decides that we'll consider giving it back. This is a violation of due process. It obviously has it completely disregards the laws that we already have. I also should have clarified, if you're adjudicated mentally defective by a court, we have that process right now. In other words, if you've already displayed behavior that you are a threat to yourself or others, they can take your firearms away. This makes it entirely subjective. No due process, no crime, no charge. Your guns are gone. Imagine you're in a city with riots going on right now. Yeah. You're a woman. Maybe you already lost your husband, like David Dorn. Mm. Maybe you already lost the protector of the house, and you have some kids and a firearm to protect yourself. And your neighbor says, you know what? I don't like her. I think she's mentally defective. Okay, thank you. Good enough for me. You're saying, well, that won't happen. Well, let me give you some examples of states that have had some. So New Jersey, under a new red flag law, a man's guns were confiscated after his doctor reported him for leaving bad reviews and an agitated phone call due to severe post-surgery pain. Yeah, you lose your second amendment. You lose your God-given right to self-preservation because of Yelp comments. Rhode Island, woman called the cops on her husband. A guy was named Edward Caligula. After an argument, requested that they conduct a wellness check. The police deemed the husband to be in imminent danger to himself and others, confiscated his guns, and then requested that he went under a psych evaluation. The case is currently now in front of the Supreme Court. So this is something, this does happen. Look, and I understand people saying we want to be safe, and there have been some shooters who, they were on the FBI should have done something. I understand, but at a certain point, when people say, hey, if it saves one life, that's not an argument.
No.
And it's also a really bad argument because guess what? Firearms are used defensively in a minimum of 500,000 times, 2-3 million times in a year. You know how many homicides with firearms in this country per year? 14,000.
Yeah.
They defend far more lives than they take, and it is a violation of fundamental human rights to take away an equalizer from the most vulnerable among us, especially if they have not committed a crime. You don't Do you understand what you're giving up? It's like, well, yeah, you know, but some crazy. You know what? Hey, look, if we don't go with red flag laws, what do we have? We have violent felons can't get firearms. Violent domestic abusers can't. People who've already been adjudicated mentally defective through the courts, have gone through the system, can't get them. Will some psychopaths maybe slip through? Those are the consequences of living in a free society. Oh, how much is your life worth? Well, you know what? How much is the life? They use this argument for everything.
Yeah.
You've collapsed the economy for decades to come. Record suicides. Good thing is the flu doesn't exist anymore. Deaths are basically down to zero, so that's nice. You say, how much is your life worth? How much is my livelihood worth? How much are our freedoms worth? How much are the lives of the 3 million people who defended them each year with firearms worth?
Yeah.
It's not a valid argument. And at a certain point, if you say, I'm willing to give up my rights for some minority report dystopian future where they can take away my rights pre-crime, look, thank you for supporting it because I now identify you as the enemy. We will have no common ground. I will find no common ground. I will fake no common ground with someone who thinks they should be able to call the cops and take my guns away with me having never committed a crime. No center, no middle ground. We're not friends. You're my enemy.
Yeah. Well, and think about it this way. So people are like, oh, that's some distant future. Well, in 2016, if you supported Donald Trump, you weren't considered a radical yet. Maybe a racist because that was the label.
Yes.
Now, let's fast forward to January 6th of this year. Let's say that you attended.
No, I was saying that you are a racist.
No, I'm not. I disagree.
And a radical.
And I'm radically racist, apparently.
Yes.
Okay. I'm a fine young radical.
January 6th, you attend a rally. You're not one of the people who stormed the Capitol. You're just somebody who goes up there because you support Donald Trump. Now you go back to your liberal state of California, and your neighbors know that you attended that rally. Everybody's labeled an insurrectionist. You've got a Donald Trump flag. They make a phone call. That is the scenario that you are now living under because you support the wrong person.
Right. The IRS targeted, under Barack Obama, targeted Tea Party groups, conservative groups.
Yeah.
People don't, for some reason, this is the thing with liberals. When remember we went to, you were a punk rock kid, No FX and Rock Against Bush and corruption and crony capitalism. It all went away when Barack Obama was president.
Yeah.
Remember, all of a sudden, the films about political corruption went away. Then they came back under Trump, and now they're going to go away again. Because inherently, Democrats are good. Look, I believe that all human beings are flawed and evil, okay, as a Christian. We are all inherently selfish and sinful. Donald Trump included, Ted Cruz included, DeSantis included, which is why I don't want them to have that much power.
Yeah.
You think, oh, no, Republicans are evil, but Joe Biden, of course, would never abuse my rights.
Oh,
Barack Obama would never abuse my rights. Let's give them all the rights. Let's pack the court. Let's give up our firearm rights. Let's remove due process, because I know that Joe Biden really has his shit together. After all, he's had 64 years in public office to get it right.
Literally, his shit's probably not together.
Not together.
I assume it's very runny.
Yeah. You know, I hate
to say, it's a good point.
I hate to make this reference, but I think if we don't look at the greatest tragedy in history for rights being taken away, then we miss a lot of the lessons. What was the one of the first things that happened in Germany was Jews were basically put on a red flag list because they were Jewish. It wasn't just them, though. It was gypsies and other undesirable peoples. And they
when
could
did
not
this
add,
happen?
And they exactly nobody talks about it because they think it's a third.
Nobody tells me anything.
Yeah. They took their guns away from all of those people groups so that when the next steps happened, you couldn't defend yourself.
Right.
At all. They had no ability.
And they encouraged
your
neighbor to call
on them. And I'm not saying we're in Nazi Germany. I'm saying that there are consequences when these
things happen. Look what happened with the Armenian genocide. Look what happened in China. Look what happened in Russia. And people try to go, yeah, well, look what happened in Australia. Yeah, you implemented a gun ban and then gun ownership and crime went up.
I don't. But they've got a lot of deadly animals. Well, that's not even an Australian accent.
It was British. Well, they were from British.
Yeah.
They were
all the rapists and prisoners.
That's why the place is so cool.
Watch Louder with Crowder live, Monday through Thursday, 10 a.m. Eastern.